Yes, there are dots on the pages. I'll be right back. I'm gonna go get something to drink. Okay, I'm back. Gotta let my tea brew. Sorry about that. I had a bunch of people show up at my house all at once. Oops. We lost our music, didn't we? That's my fault. Steven and Faith showed up. And what do you mean, what? There we go. These pins are so picky. I'm gonna have to get some good gel pens to go with this book. Because I like this ink, but again, the pens are so picky. What didn't you hear? Do I need to turn the music down? Is it too loud? Okay. color do I want to do the liquid? Let's do boysenberry. I'm not super happy with this flower. I think Skeletor came in earlier. Oh, Rex just joined me too. This back page is like my little scratch page. Oof. I'm gonna have to wipe this down. There we go. Hey. How's it going, UK gaming guy? Not bad. Not bad. Just getting back into doing my bullet journaling. It is. It is just a blackout book. First time I've worked with a book like this, so I'm pretty excited about it. But I know I'm gonna have to get some special pens. Like these work good. Like they're specifically meant for this kind of book, but like I think I mentioned earlier, they're kind of difficult to work with because they get real picky on when they want to work. Yeah, I picked up this book from the brand is Archer and Olive. Let's see. Yeah, Archer and Olive. They've got some really nice journals, and this one, I mean, it's got the little potion bottles on there, which is kind of the theme I'm going to use, at least for the first little bit of this book. And then you've got the holographic shift gilding on the pages, so it's really neat. Yeah, this flower's looking kind of crazy. But don't worry, I've got a process. If all else fails, we'll cover it up with a sticker. Let's let that dry. It's really wet. Well, it's currently kind of this coral color, but I'm about to go back over and darken the lines once it dries with this boysenberry color, so we can have some nice strong line work. See? I haven't explored a whole lot with these pens, but these pens are apparently blendable. But I gotta be careful about not putting too much ink on a page and causing it to oversaturate and start to rip the page. Add some of this vintage rose in here just to give it some variation. You probably can't see much on the camera because the camera kind of blows out some of the colors, but eh. I don't know. part of me really wants to fill in the liquid for the water, but another part of me is like, that's a lot. And it'll probably wash out that flower, so I don't think I'm gonna do it. Not everything's gotta be filled in, right? Done. That is our key basic setup. Now we're going to move on to the index page. I think you're right, Mama. Gonna kind of stick to doing just line drawings. I would say the only downside I have found to this paper so far is that when you erase, it leaves this kind of ugly smudge mark that you don't see on normal, on white paper. So, and I'm used to sketching out all of my stuff first, so I'm going to have to be more careful with that, but that's just gonna come with me getting some practice in. Eventually I'll get to where I don't need to sketch it out and I can just start inking things in as is. Well, thank you, Mama. I know you like roses. Alright. I keep going back to this page so I can see what these colors look like on here. That is a frustrating pen. Maybe I just need to shake it up. This one's a little harder for me to see. If my headphones get in the way from me leaning forward too much, please let me know. Oops, keep hitting that, losing our music. I need to like cut out one of these pages and just have it here as a scratch page so I can get everything to work right.
God, come on.
This page is going to be a lot. Before I get started on that, I'm gonna take out my tea bags. How to get my iced tea. Such a weird southerner. I like iced tea, but I don't like it sweet. Lime instead of lemon, preferably. Hey, buddy, how's it going? Get our parchment paper set up. What's the difference between this and this? Oh, how freaking weird. Cider yellow and whatever this color is. Whatever it is, it doesn't seem to be doing it very brightly. So I think we'll use the cider for the parchment papers. See, I gotta have the yearly set up for October, November, and December, and then we'll do January through December of next year over here. Thank you. that one.
Thank you.
Oh no. It's too dark. Damn. Phew! Excuse me. Thanks, Mom. All right, I think I'm getting to about the end of my day. I think we've got a lot done. I still have to get this page. You can see the... I'm gonna fill this in and then get all of 2022 laid out. And that'll be fun, I think. So, yeah. And that's our blackout bullet journal. Looks pretty different from the other one. This is our comparison. Here's our key. And index. I put it on the same page over here. And then this is our full year. So different style artwork. I think it's nice. I'm enjoying it. We'll see what we can explore with this blackout journal. And see how we can go. I gotta find some, since I can't do watercolor on this unless I can find some really, really pigmented stuff. Let's see if I can. There. Well, I think the only one who's still here is my mom. So, have a good night, Mom. Thanks for hanging out with me. And I'll probably be back on later on tomorrow or next week. All right. Bye.